There's barely room for science to get past!
It's that time once again, the final moments before lights out and the charge down to turn one. Who will come out on top at Paul Ricard today? Well, we'll find out soon as we get the French Grand Prix underway. Mastering a lap of Paul Ricard means getting to know 15 corners. 6 go to the left and 9 go to the right for an overall lap distance of 3.6 miles. The two halves of the long Mistral straight are separated by a heavy braking zone into a potential overtaking hotspot at the chicane. And watch out for drivers running onto the distinctive coloured stripes, which are low in grip and highly abrasive. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Russell, Sergio Perez, and Verstappen. Mick Schumacher, Gasly, Tsunoda, and Kevin Magnussen. Bottas, Joe, Fernando Alonso, and Ocon. Latifi, Ricciardo, Lando Norris, and Sebastian Vettel. Albon, and Lance Stroll brings the grid to a close. It's almost time for those 5 red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
this is Mark. I need you to stop cutting the corners. If you keep it up, the stewards are going to give you a penalty. Okay, mate, race control, I'm afraid I'm not happy with your creative interpretation of track limits. They've given you a 3-second penalty. Nice overtake. corners, the stewards are going to give you a penalty. Be careful.
Excellent win from Ferrari. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.